When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars. But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows, maybe life is looking for us too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome. We need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
Welcome to another edition of The Nate Moore Show. Our show is brought to you each week by Reliable Heating and Cooling. I'm your host, Savannah Kennedy. Joining me is Coach Moore. Coach, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Savannah, for having me on.
Coach, your Tigers beat a very good Austin Town Fitch team 31-21 last Friday. Your team is now 4-2. The Tigers fell behind 14-0 early in the second quarter, but fought back to take a 17-14 halftime lead. How do you feel about the game up until that point?
Well, it's pretty much a tale of two quarters. Going down by two touchdowns on the road is obviously not good, especially against a quarterback as good as the one that we played. But we just kept swinging and played, I wouldn't even say played better, but we made some plays in the second half. Proud of them.
Fitch took the lead in the third quarter, but your Tigers scored 14 unanswered points the rest of the way and finished with a 10-point win. Can you summarize your second half, your thoughts on the second half for us?
Our kids just played hard. They played hard, And made some plays when the plays were there to be made. That's what we aim to do, basically. We want to go out and play hard no matter what. And we know that we got to make some plays along the way. We're going to make some plays. We're going to, go up and get a ball and complete a big pass and things like that. Get a big defensive stop or force a fumble. You have to make some plays along the way when you play good teams. And we were able to make enough plays to win.
Yeah, of course. Your offense finished with 283 yards of total offense. Camden Beasley carried the ball 25 times for 85 yards and a touchdown. What is the key to his success?
Well, he had one longer run towards the beginning of the game, which was an outside zone, and it was blocked up pretty well, and picked up 30 or 35 yards on that one play there early, and then didn't really have a lot going until we got into the fourth quarter, the second half, and we were still facing a loaded box, but we had completed enough passes to where. And even if those guys were still in the box, they had to keep an eye on some things other than just the running back. And so that kind of slows down how they're able to swarm to the running back when we hand them the ball. So that allowed us to hit some creases and gain some yards. And Cam scored a touchdown on the ground in the second half. That was good. So there's been several games this year where we've just kind of ground the defensive line up and things just really started to pop in the second half. This one wasn't like that. It was, we're facing loaded box, which, that means there's more guys there that we can block, and we had to throw them out of that. And we did a pretty good job of that.
Freshman quarterback Jaden Slaughter started his first varsity game and threw for a total of 205 yards and 3 touchdowns. What did you see from Jalen that impressed you?
I thought he did a nice job on Friday You know, he's very calm, cool, collected, which is a great quality for a quarterback. You know, you want that guy to be the same guy every snap, you know, no matter what happens. If he, you know, throws a pick, throws an interception, I mean, you know, you want him to generally be the same guy all the time. So, you know, he's done a good job with that. You know, he doesn't get consumed by the moment. You know, it's not too big for him. He handles himself very, very well. And, you know, those are the things that, you know, the good quarterbacks that I've had have all shared those qualities.
Mm-hmm. Austin Brawley was once again all over the field, making the plays on offense, defense, and special teams. After watching him play last year and then put in the work on the during the offseason, could you predict he would be making this much of an impact every week?
I mean, we thought it was going to be really good, but, you know, I don't think anybody could have predicted this. You know, I think he's been the best player in every game that we've played. You know, he's absolutely dynamic, you know, in all three phases.
In a moment, we'll talk with the Tiger player, but first, this word from Reliable Heating and Cooling.
There was a time when 10 miles to the gallon was acceptable. Today's 40-plus mile per gallon cars weren't even in the rearview mirror back then. Of course, this Lennox air conditioner wasn't on the radar either. It's solar ready, the quietest, most energy efficient air conditioner you can own. It's time to live in the now.
Call Reliable Heating and Cooling for the most advanced technology in heating and air conditioning. When you're ready to live in the now, call Reliable Heating and Cooling.
Lennox, innovation never felt so good.
Thank you, Reliable Heating and Cooling. Joining me now is senior linebacker and tight end, Nate DePue. Nate, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
First of all, congratulations on being named one of the unit leaders for this year's team. Tell us how you felt when you found out you were selected as a unit leader.
Well, it was one shocking and like a big achievement for me because I never actually thought I would be a leader as for the Madison Tigers. So it was a major milestone for me. So.
Yeah. Let's go back a bit now. How old were you when you first started playing football and who taught you the game?
I think I was 5 years old and my father taught me the game.
Nice. You're a starting linebacker on the Tiger defense. Describe some of the skills necessary to be successful as a linebacker.
You got to be very physical. You got to be, you know, head in the game, practicing 24/7. Just got to live, eat, breathe football. So.
Yeah. Your team fell behind 14-0 last week against Austintown Finch. After that, the defense gave up just 7 more points. How were you able to slow Finch down, especially in the second half?
Well, when we went into the halftime, we found out some weaknesses that we were facing, and then we were told what to do, and we fixed the weaknesses. So.
Yeah. As a unit leader, what is your message to your teammates as you get ready to face Euclid?
My message to my teammates would be, let's have a focused week of practice, and just do everything right to get prepared for Friday.
Thanks, Nate. Coach Moore will be joining us after we take this timeout on the Nate Moore Show.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Nate Moore Show. Coach, we just spoke with senior linebacker and tight end Nate Nate DePue. Tell us more about Nate and what he brings to your football team.
Nate's he's a very intense linebacker. He cares a lot about our football team and this program. And you can see that in the way that he plays. Plays with great effort, great intensity, and very physical.
This week, your Tigers come back home to face Euclid on Friday night. What can you tell us about the Panthers?
Yeah, they're a good football team. They don't have a great record, but they've played a great schedule. One of the toughest schedules in the state of Ohio. And they've got some good players. If they can get things together, they could be a really dangerous team. So, we're going to have to play really, really well. They've got some really dynamic receivers, a quarterback that's good, a good running back, and they're good on the defensive line and in the secondary. And they, similar to what we saw last week, we're going to see a loaded box again. And we're going to have to do some things to get them out of that.
Maslin, has Maslin ever played Euclid in football?
It's the first meeting.
How did this mashup come about?
I mean, we were both open, generally. I mean, there's not a lot going on week seven. Usually what is going on is not, like we're not going to play a Division VII school, stuff like that. So those odd weeks like that, it generally comes down to, the last two people to ask anybody to the dance, essentially. And so, we paired up.
Unfortunately, injuries can take place playing sports at any level. Can you highlight for us the people that take care of our Tigers when they're injured?
Yeah, Sam Allweiler and Lee Coons, two of the best in the business. Sam comes to us from Altman. And does a fantastic job, and Lee Koontz is he was in Major League Baseball for about 30 years. Actually retired from Major League Baseball, and so we've got two guys that are two of the best in the business taking care of our Tigers.
We want to thank Coach Moore and senior linebacker and tight end Nate DePue for joining us on the show this week. The Nate Moore Show has been brought to you by Reliable Heating and Cooling. I'm your host, Savannah Kennedy. Thanks for watching, and as always, go Tigers.
Hello, and welcome to the Stark County Humane Society. Today we're going to give you a few pointers when considering adopting a new furry friend. All animals here at the Stark County Humane Society are spayed, neutered, microchipped, vaccinated, dewormed, and if old enough, heartworm tested for our canine friends. Adopters will receive a free exam within 2 weeks of adoption at local veterinarian hospitals. We encourage all adopters to take full advantage of this. A one-time adoption fee is required for your new furry friend. When you adopt, you get an awesome adoption packet that includes treats for your new fur baby and savings for you. But this is not where the cost of adoption stops. Did you know the average cost of an animal like a new puppy or kitten can cost up to $500 annually? This includes annual veterinarian visits, preventative care, and everyday supplies like crate, litter, food, toys. But I hope this doesn't scare you away. Adopting an animal is a huge responsibility and a commitment. Please take the time to consider the cost of adopting a new pet into your family today. I hope to see you soon at the Stark County Humane Society. Please visit our website or visit us on social media for more information.
Maslin City Schools is proud to have one of the top career technical education programs in the state of Ohio, recently receiving a number one ranking of the 93 districts in the area of achievement. Our Career Technical Education Department offers 14 pathways preparing students for college and careers. All students have the opportunity to participate and compete in their Career Technical Student Organization, as well as obtain valuable experience in the field while earning aligned industry credentials and or college credit in high school. Visit maslinschools.org for more information.
Welcome to this week's edition of Swing, featuring Tiger Swing Band Director Jason Neal. We're on the air with you every Wednesday night following the Nate Moore Show. Our show is brought to you by Howard's Tiger's Rags in downtown Massillon. I'm your host, Miguel Reyes, and here with me is Mr. Neal. Welcome to the show, Mr. Neal.
Thanks for having me, Miguel.
All right. First up, let's talk about last week's halftime show. Your band played during the halftime show at Austintown Fitch game. Mm-hmm. How did that show go?
Well, I thought the kids did a great job at Fitch on Friday night. We have certain goals that we try to meet every performance, and we graded out the band, meeting all our goals that night. So we were very proud of their performance. I thought the Fitch crowd was receptive to us, and I thought the kids did a great job.
Yeah. On Saturday night, your band performed at Dover Band Show. Tell us more about that.
Well, the Dover Band Show, we had a great night, beautiful weather, lots of supportive fans there, a great crowd, a lot of excited bands to be at a band show again. It was nice to see a lot of good bands that night. I thought our kids had a wonderful night of performance. I think it might have been our best sound of the year. The weather just starting to get a little bit colder, I think, helps that sound carry just a little bit.
Yeah.
But we're also at a point in the season where, our skill's getting a little bit higher and the kids are getting a little bit more comfortable performing. And I thought they had a lot of energy that night, and I thought they represented us very well. So we were very pleased with that show as well. And again, the goals that we set for ourselves for each performance, we met that night as well. So we had a real good weekend with the band.
That's good to hear. What are some determining factors when it comes to deciding if your band will accept an invitation to participate in someone else's band show in any given year?
Well, we'll get different invitations from different schools. We try to kind of spread around the wealth, if you will. We don't always go to the same band shows every year. We haven't been to the Dover Band Show in quite a few years. I'm not even sure how many it's been, but they come to our show pretty regularly. So we were glad to be able to return the favor to Dover and go to their show this year. Again, sometimes we'll do, the Jackson Band Show or the Lake Band Show, and everybody's got a band show at some point in the season. So we have to check our availability. We have to check how frequently we've been there. And again, we can't do everybody's band show every year, or we'd be doing, every Friday night and every Saturday night all season. And that's, I think that's too much to ask of our students. So we try to pick one or two shows a year that we can go and be a part of.
How do you choose which halftime show you'll perform at any given show?
Well, when it's an away football game, we have to take the clock into consideration. And so we have to be under 10 minutes of our time when we're the visiting band at a football game. And then we have to make sure we can take that show on the road, so to speak. For example, we did a costume show that we can't do that costume show on the road. We're not going to be able to take all those costumes and go change in the middle of a game when we're the visiting band.
Yeah.
Or sometimes we'll have a show that's a little longer than 10 minutes. That kind of is ruled out. We can't take that on the road. So this year, our Triple Threat show has kind of been our default travel show. And we did that Friday and Saturday night. And it was well received both times. But to answer your question, we have to look at the timing of the show and some of the auxiliary or props or different effects that we have in the show. And sometimes those shows are designed and can only be done in our stadium.
All right, we'll have more with Mr. Neal here on Swing. But first, here's a word from Howard's Tiger Rags.
Howard's Tiger Rags in downtown Massillon has the best selection of tiger apparel in the area. And once again, Howard's Tiger Rags is the proud sponsor of the Swing TV show on WHS-TV. Be sure to check out their large selection of infant and toddler apparel. You can even dress up your favorite pet in tiger gear. See their large selection of memorabilia along with mugs and glasses and your favorite Tiger jewelry. How about a license plate holder or a Tiger hat? Howard's has one to fit your style. Stop in at Howard's Tiger Rags in downtown Massillon and don't forget to like them on Facebook.
Thank you, Howard's Tiger Rags, and welcome back to Swing. The role of the drum major has been a major part of the swing band tradition for many years. Tell us about some of the history and the fact that you have two drum major sets this year.
Well, the drum major role goes way, way back, and I believe that my assistant director, Jen Smith-Heisler's grandfather, was the first drum major here in Massillon. I'm pretty sure I'm getting that history right, but there's a long history, and if you dig around on our website, you can find who the drum major was every year since 1938, and George Byrd started the whole swing band. But you know, that is a student leader role. Obviously, it's looked a little bit different over the years, but we have two drum majors this year, as just alluded to. Brandon Johnson is a senior, and Miriam Joseph is a sophomore. And you know, we chose to have two drum majors this year because I really felt that both of them had earned the opportunity to get out onto the field and learn how to do this role. At the end of the day, this is a an educational experience, and I think both of them have learned a lot in their second year together. I think they're starting to really hit their stride, so to speak, as a team, and you know, they both have different strengths, and we really think they're both doing a great job this year. And as the more time they spend together, I think the better the two of them get. I would assume that next year, Miriam, as a senior, we'd probably be back to one drum major, but I have no idea who's coming up, you know, next, which younger members are looking to try out for that position in the future.
Yeah. I'm sure you've seen plenty of other bands that feature dance teams, flag units, or other groups. Would you ever consider adding something like that to your band, or are there already many traditions in place here that something like that couldn't be changed?
You know, I've always appreciated groups like that along with their band. I would agree with what you just said that, you know, the tradition here in Massillon is, you know, a drum major, majorettes, a mascot. That's kind of our auxiliary group. And, you know, tradition is a funny word, especially around here. And
yeah.
I don't see that ever changing here, at least under my time. Again, I do appreciate those types of group, but each band has its own identity. And, you know, I watch other bands, but I don't want to be other bands. We have so many great traditions here in Massillon, yeah. And we embrace who we are, and we try to do that to the best of our ability.
Yeah. Speaking of traditions, are there many with your band, or do you have any favorite traditions that you look forward to each week or year?
You know, I think obviously we have many traditions, and there's so many. It's hard to even put them all into words. They kind of happen from week to week, or month to month, or you know, year to year. I would say my favorite tradition is the McKinley week, and it just everything from Monday to Saturday, that whole week has got all these little traditions, and and how special and set apart that week is from all the other weeks. Just going around the town on Friday and playing all over, I think that's probably one of my favorite traditions, that the band just goes around and spreads Tiger Rag and Tiger Spirit everywhere we go that entire Friday to get everybody ready for the game. But a lot of great traditions. It's hard to pick just one.
Reasonable. Please give us details about the week's halftime show, as our favorite football team is back home to face Euclid.
This week we're having junior high marching night, which we're very, very excited to do again because we didn't get to do last year. So we have a group of 7th and 8th grade band students who will be joining the swing band at halftime for the last two songs. And none of them have done it before. So they are extremely excited. We're extremely excited to welcome them. They're going to sit with us during the first half of the game, and they're going to play with us during the first half this year, which we've never done that before. So another level of our excitement for us. But you asked about the show. We're going to do our opening routine, and we're going to do a theme called Behind the Mask. And it's music. We've got Darth Vader in the Imperial March. We've got Batman and Phantom of the Opera. So a lot of cool music. The 7th and 8th graders are going to join us for that Batman and Phantom of the Opera. And so we got a little Behind the Mask this week.
That's interesting. Please, how do you go about preparing the junior high band members to perform along with the high school band students this week?
Well, it's going to be October 1st is the game. And since the first day of school, we've been getting our 7th and 8th graders ready to play these songs. They're going to play a couple songs with us in the stands and then two songs on the field. So they've been working on four pieces of music for about a month. And they're going to have two rehearsals with the band, one on Thursday night and then one on Friday after school, so our run-through. And we're going to show them where to go on the field and where to stand and how to get on and off the field. And it's not a lot of rehearsal time, but we don't do a lot of marching with them. It's mostly about the music for them. So they've been working and preparing for about a month. And I just want to thank James Gates, Montana Hollis, and Chris Nussbaum, who are our middle school directors, for all of the work that they've put in to get those 7th and 8th graders as prepared as we can make them for Friday night.
Thank you, Mr. Neal. And that will do for this edition of Swing. Swing is brought to you each week by Howard's Tiger Rags in downtown Massillon. I'm your host, Miguel Reyes. Thank you for watching, and as always, go Tigers.
Bye, sweetie. I love you.
Bye, Mommy. I love you.
No matter where life takes you, MCTV helps make sure you're never far from home.
Hi. Are you being good for Daddy?
Yes. Can we read a bedtime story?
MCTV connects you to home because that's what matters most.
Good night. Sweet dreams.
MCTV. We go the extra smile.